welcome to story time. One day, a monk approached the great Buddha. The monk wanted a new woolen shawl. Buddha asked the monk, "What had happened to your old shawl?" Then Buddha asked the monk a number of questions. Did Buddha give the monk a new shawl? My dear sweeties, would you like to know that? Then come on, let's read a new story. Read and find out the answer. What happened to the shawl? One day, the great Buddha was taking a walk around the monastery. He was approached by a monk who wanted a new woolen shawl. The Buddha asked him, "What has happened to your old shawl?" "It had become very old and worn out, so I am using it as a bedsheet," replied the monk. The Buddha asked again, "But what happened to your old bedsheet?" "Master, that bedsheet got old with use. It was worn and torn, so I cut it up and made a pillow cover out of it," replied the monk. "But there certainly was a pillow cover before you made a new one. What did you do to your old pillow cover?" asked the Buddha. "My head had rubbed a million times against the old pillow cover and had made a big hole in it. So I made a doormat out of it," replied the monk in earnest. Gautama Buddha was not satisfied by this answer. He always delved deep into every issue. He asked the monk, "Tell me, what did you do with your old doormat?" The monk replied with folded hands, "Master, the old doormat had got totally worn out. After being used for so long, the warp and the weft had come out. So I took the cotton fibers and braided a wick out of them. Later, I burned the cotton wick in the oil lamp." The Buddha smiled after listening to the monk. The monk got a new shawl.
Hey, have you enjoyed the story? Then come on, tell me, what is the title of the story?
What happened to the shawl? The story upholds the slogans: recycle, reuse,
reduce. My dear sweeties, let's sing our slogan. Recycle, reuse, reduce. Recycle, reuse, reduce, oh so wise. Recycle, reuse, reduce, oh so wise. For a greener world, let's all rise. Paper, plastic, let's reduce waste. Let's be smart, let's play our part. Recycle, reuse, reduce, hooray! Recycle, reuse, reduce, oh so wise. Learn to carry it every day. 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 My dear sweeties, let's sing the song with music. Are you ready? Come on, let's sing and enjoy together. Music. Recycle, reuse, reduce, oh so wise. For a greener world, let's all rise. Paper, plastic, let's reduce waste. Let's be smart, let's play our part. Recycle, reuse, reduce, hooray. Learn to carry out every day. Learn to carry it every day. Learn to carry it every day. Learn to carry it every day. Recycle, reuse, reduce. We buy, use and throw away things without thinking much about them. We buy much more than we need. Our mantra seems to be buy more, throw more. We misuse earth's resources like water, trees, sand and soil and produce tons of junk that become mountains of garbage. But has it always been like this? Have we Indians always been wasteful? No. History tells us that Indians have been very frugal and sensible. We believe that every object has several uses, not one, but many lives. The concept of reuse and recycle has very deep roots in the Indian culture. This story is 2500 years old, set in the times when the great sage and teacher Gautama Buddha lived. It shows a deep respect and sensitivity for the material world. It has many lessons for us. Hey, it's craft time. My dear sweeties, look. Cardboard boxes. When we buy things, we will get cardboard boxes like this. Hey, don't throw them. Cardboard boxes are recyclable, but it's better to reuse. Come on, let's make an interesting thing by using this cardboard box. I'm taking this box. Now look. I'm going to cut the top. Now we can take craft paper and paste them like this using the glue. I'm covering the cardboard box. Look. Now we can decorate the box. Using craft paper, you can decorate it. The box is ready. You can use colorful ribbons, color paper, whatever you have, you can decorate the box and we can use it as pen holder. Hey, look. I can keep my sketch pen, pencils. A beautiful pen holder is ready. My dear sweeties, try to make a pen holder like this. You can take cardboard boxes like this. Then you can make any other things by using this cardboard box. Don't throw them away. Make use of it. And what is your creativity? Let's see. Try to make new things and take a video. Send your videos to us. This is our email ID. Thank you. My dear sweeties, it's time to wind up. Let's meet again with a new story. Till then, cha-cha.